mathematicians, today we see one nice linear algebra problem asked in the CSIR exam part C part. Let me phrase the question. Let n be a positive integer and v be an n plus 1 dimensional vector space. Okay. Usually we always use n dimensional vector space. When they say n plus 1 dimensional, you remember it. Otherwise, you might end up in making minor mistakes because of n plus 1 in place of n. Okay, let's see why it is important to notice n plus 1. If e1, e2, etc., en plus 1 is a basis of v, and t from v to v is a linear transformation satisfying t of ei equal to ei plus 1 for I equal to 1 to n, and t of en plus 1 is 0, then they have given four options. We'll come back to the options later when we understand this linear transformation little bit. Okay. So to understand this linear transformation, let's take n equal to 2. Okay. In n equal to 2, this linear transformations satisfies the condition e1 is mapped to e2. Okay. e2 is mapped to e3. E3 is mapped to 0. See, because n equal to 2, that is what this condition is says. Okay. Now we can easily form the matrix of this linear transformation. So you see, the first column is the image of E1. So image of E1 is E2. Therefore, I have put E2, the standard basis vector E2. T of E2 is E3. E2 goes to E3, so we get E3 here. Then the E3 is goes to 0. Therefore, the image of E3 is 0 vector. Okay. Now, for n equal to 2, we are getting this matrix. You from this, you can understand that for n equal to, in general n also, you're going to get the strictly lower triangular matrix. Okay. Because the first column anyway going to be E1. So this entry is going to be 0. Second column going to be the first column is E2. Therefore, this entry going to be 0. Second column going to be E3. Therefore, these two entries going to be 0. And then in the orbit, suppose if it is a 10 by 10 matrix, for n equal to 9, this will be E2, E3, E4, E5, E6. So basically, these zeros are going to keep decreasing. Okay, therefore, you will get this strictly lower triangular kind of setup. Therefore, all the eigenvalues are 0 for this matrix, for linear transformation satisfying this condition. So, if all the eigenvalues are 0, then its characteristic polynomial will be x cube. Okay, therefore, it satisfies its characteristic polynomial. We get t cube equal to 0. So, if n equal to 2, then t cube equal to 0. Now we'll go to the options and we try to answer them. So our basic understanding is, once you know the linear transformation, we know the structure of its matrix. It is going to be strictly upper triangular. Once you know that, answer is immediate. Okay, so basically it is a nilpotent linear transformation. Okay, so first option, they are saying that trace of t is non-zero. Eigenvalues are 0. So trace is sum of the eigenvalues. Therefore, trace should be 0. Therefore, first option is wrong. Second option, they are saying that rank of t is n. Okay, note that this is a n plus 1 dimensional vector space. Okay, and we are so here is the one where you can easily make mistake. Okay, what is rank of this matrix? Okay, so if you look at this matrix, clearly it has rank 2. Okay, and where 2 is n. Okay, therefore rank of t is equal to n is true in case of this matrix. Okay, but why in general rank of t is equal to n? Because what is rank? Rank is like the dimension of column space. Okay, so you take the column vectors and look at the vector space spanned by the columns, and the dimension of this vector space will be the rank. Okay, this is one definition. That is one definition. So what is the column space consist of? First column will be E2, second column will be E3, etc., etc. Then the nth column will be En plus 1. then the last column will be 0, okay, because for I equal to 1 you get 2, for I equal to 2 you get e3, so e2 e3 it goes till en, image of en will be en plus 1, then for the last vector en plus 1 the answer is 0. Okay, therefore this is the column space, the vector space spanned by these vectors. How many vectors are there? You see, starting from 2 till n plus 1, all the standard basis vectors are there. Therefore, the dimension is n. Therefore, rank T is n is true. There is another way to see that. If you look at this 2 by 2 block, this is an identity matrix. So, if you in arbitrary n case also, you can visualize that this block always going to be identity block. Okay. So, therefore, so if it is a 3 by 3 matrix, you are getting a 2 by 2 identity block here, and full determinant is clearly 0. Okay, therefore, the full determinant, so full matrix is not invertible, but there is a highest order non-vanishing minor of size n minus 1. Okay, if it is a n by n matrix, it has size n minus 1, but we are talking about n plus 1 cross n plus 1 matrix, so this is a minor of size n by n. That is why this n plus 1 is coming into the picture. So we get rank of T is n. Okay. So rank you try to visualize as a highest order non-vanishing minor, or you visualize as a dimension of the column space. In either way, you will get rank of T is n. Okay. Now if rank of T is n, then the nullity of T is 1 by rank nullity theorem. Note that this is a n plus 1 by n plus 1 matrix. Okay. So, if V is a, maybe I'll write this also for n plus 1 matrix, because we are talking about n plus 1 matrix. So, if dimension of V is a n plus 1, and if you have a linear transformation from V to V, then this n plus 1 is equal to rank of T plus nullity of T. We just saw that rank is n. Okay. Therefore, if rank is n, nullity has to be 1. Therefore, nullity of T is 1 is correct. In then the last option, they are saying that we already saw nullity, it is a nilpotent linear transformation. So, when you see T power n, so it means that actually it means that T power n plus 1 is equal to 0. Okay. See, there is a confusion of this n plus 1. T is a linear transformation from n plus 1 dimensional vector space to n plus 1 dimensional vector space. Therefore, T is matrix corresponds to T will be a n plus 1 by n plus 1 matrix. Okay. But here they are saying that T power n equal to T is a 0 map. Okay. But that we don't know. We get T power n plus 1 is equal to 0. Okay. Suppose they are saying that T, for example, n equal to 2, we get this matrix. It is a 3 by 3 matrix because we are looking at n plus 1 cross n plus 1 matrix. If this matrix, if this result is true, then if you square this matrix, because n equal to 2, if you square this matrix, you should get 0. Okay. But if you check whether the square of this matrix is 0, you will see that the square of this matrix is not equal to 0. Therefore, last option is false. Okay. Okay, therefore, so we conclude that option B and option 2 and 3 are the only right options. Okay. Okay, guys. So if you learn something new from this video, please click the like button and share with your friends and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.